To have a successful onboarding experience to the cloud service for Microsoft Dynamics 365 for finance and operations, you must always know the health of your environments. You must also be able to troubleshoot any health issues that occur. Microsoft Dynamics Lifecycle Services, also known as LCS, is the administration center for finance and operations. It contains a collection of monitoring and diagnostic tools that can help you gain an accurate view of the environments that you manage. In this video, we'll show how to monitor key performance counters by using LCS environment monitoring. Open LCS, and then open the appropriate project. In the Environment section, select the environment to view, and then click Full Details. On the Environment Details page, click Environment Monitoring to open the Monitoring and Diagnostics portal. On the Environment Monitoring page, on the Activity tab, find the SQL Utilization chart. SQL utilization is shown in Database Transaction Units, also known as DTUs. For a single Microsoft Azure SQL database at a specific performance level in a service tier, Microsoft guarantees a specific level of resources and a predictable level of performance. These levels are independent of any other database in the Azure cloud. The amount of resources is calculated as a number of DTUs and is a blended measure of CPU, memory, and input/output, also known as I/O. For more information about DTUs, see the Database Transaction Units, DTUs, and Elastic Database Transaction Units, EDTUs, article on docs.microsoft.com. In the UTC time field, specify the end time to verify SQL utilization for, and then set the period minutes field to -60. Click Submit Time. The chart will show you the DTU of the database for a period of 1 hour. Verify whether there is any period that is a high DTU load of up to 100%. You can zoom in on any period in the chart. Hover over the period that you're interested in. Click and hold the left mouse button and drag to select the period. The chart will zoom in on that period. To reset the zoom, click Reset Zoom. Scroll down to the User Load and Activity Load sections of the Activity tab to further analyze the activity. Scroll back up and click View Raw Logs. On the Raw Logs page, in the Query Name field, select Slow Queries. Click Search. Review the list of slow queries and identify any queries that must be tuned. A query is considered slow if its execution time is longer than 100 milliseconds. You can click Export Grid to export the results to a comma-separated values file, also known as a CSV file. Next, we'll look at key performance counters for the various virtual machines. On the Environment Monitoring page in LCS, click the Health Metrics tab. Click System. Key performance counters are shown for the various virtual machines. Click the magnifying glass that contains a plus sign to zoom in on the graph. Click 1W to see the history of the past week. The Memory Available, MBytes counter, shows the amount of physical memory in bytes that's available to processes that run on the server. The amount is calculated by adding the amount of space on the zeroed, free, and standby memory lists. Verify that enough memory is still available for the various virtual machines. The CPU utilization percent counter monitors the amount of time that the central processing unit, also known as CPU, spends running a thread that isn't idle. A consistent state of 80 to 90% might indicate that the server is overutilized. Verify this counter for the various virtual machines. Next, we'll look at SQL performance metrics. On the Environment Monitoring page in LCS, click the SQL Insights tab. Then, click the Performance Metrics tab. In the Start Time, UTC, and End Time, UTC, fields, enter the start and end times for a period in Coordinated Universal Time, also known as UTC. Click Apply. In the Metrics section, you can see multiple charts of SQL query executions for the specified period. These charts are ordered by duration, logical input/output, CPU time, execution count, and total wait time. In any of the charts, you can zoom in on an area. Hover over the area that you're interested in, click and hold the left mouse button, and drag to select the area. This chart will zoom in on that area. To reset the zoom, click Reset Zoom. Click any of the bars in the chart. Notice that the selected bar is now highlighted in yellow. Scroll down to the Query Details section and click the Trend tab. In the charts, you can see how the query resolution for the selected query changed over time. In terms of duration, logical input/output, CPU time, execution count, and total wait time. Click the SQL Statement tab to view the query text for the selected query, together with key performance characteristics. Click Download Query Plan to download the query plan. You should now have enough information to further analyze the query and implement any required tuning. On the Environment Monitoring page in LCS, click the SQL Insights tab, and then click the SQL Now tab. You'll see the current activity on the SQL Azure database. There are three sections: currently executing statements, locking statements, and lock info. All this information can help you gain real-time performance insight into the finance and operations system. This brings us to the end of this presentation. We hope you found this information useful. Thank you for watching.